There are lots of ways to make something look animated, but the basic principle is always the same. If you take a bunch of drawings or pictures where each one is just a little different from the last one and flip through them fast enough, it'll look like your picture is moving. Back in the good old days, they used to draw all these pictures by hand, and it would take so long just to make a 3-second animation. Luckily for us, we live in the future. It's actually really easy to make a simple animation with code, and I will show you how. Over on the right, you can see there's a cute little car on a lovely yellow background. And yes, I did design that car myself, thanks. Anyways, over here, you can see we're setting this beautiful background color, and the car doesn't have any outlines, so we're calling this no stroke function. And then here, we're making a new variable x, the position of the car, and giving it a value of 10, and you can see if we change this value, then it moves the car back and forth. Bring it back to 10. And then over here, we're setting the fill color of the car and drawing two rectangles for the car body. So it looks like this first rectangle is for the bottom, and this rectangle is for the top. And then here, we're doing the same thing with the wheels. We set the fill color and draw two ellipses, one at x plus 25 and x plus 75. And finally, we get to the new stuff. This thing here is called a function definition. You'll learn all about those later, so for now, kind of just look at it and memorize what it looks like. The important things to notice are this word, draw, and these brackets, this opening bracket here and this closing bracket here. This whole thing is what we call the draw loop, or the animation loop. And everything that you put inside these brackets gets run over and over again really, really fast. That's why it's called a loop. And then everything outside these brackets gets run only once at the very beginning of the program. So the first step in animating is to move all your drawing code into the brackets so that your picture will get drawn over and over. So let's do that. I'm just gonna pull all this drawing code and then plop it down inside my loop. And to remind myself that this block of code goes inside these brackets, I'm just gonna indent it all by selecting everything and pressing tab. And now I know that this code is inside the brackets. So as you can tell, everything just looks totally the same. Nothing has changed. Because the first time we run this draw loop, the computer is going to go, okay, make a new variable x, set it to 10, draw two rectangles, draw two ellipses. And then it's going to go all the way back to the top and say, make a new variable x, set it to 10, draw two rectangles, draw two ellipses. And then make a new variable x, set it to 10, draw two rectangles. Same exact thing. Nothing has changed, so duh, you're not going to see any animation. It's just drawing the same rectangles and ellipses on top of the old ones. Remember what we said, if we want to make something look animated, you need to change your drawing a little bit at a time. So if I want my car to move forward, I should change the value of this x variable, right? So yeah, let's just like make it 11. Ah, no, but now it's just going to be 11 every single time. How the heck am I supposed to get the value of x to keep changing when the computer just runs the same code over and over? Okay, watch this magic trick. Remember, this var x makes a new variable. When we have it inside the draw loop like this, it makes a new variable called x every single time. What we need to do is make this variable outside the draw loop. That way, it'll only make it once. And then, every time the computer runs this code and sees the variable x, it'll reuse the same variable from before using the last value we assigned to it. So I'm just going to do that. I'm going to take this variable, and we're going to make it outside of the draw loop. So right now, it's only making that variable once. And every time it runs into this variable x, it's going to reuse the same variable. And right now, the last value we assigned to it was 11. So it's always going to be 11. And here's where the magic comes in. Somewhere in the draw loop, we're going to change the value of x to be a little more than it used to be, like this. X gets the old value of x plus, let's say, 1. Yay, it works! Except, it's so smeary. And if you're wondering why it looks that way, it's because we forgot to draw this background inside the draw loop. So it's drawing the car over and over again, but you can see all the old cars underneath the new one. So if I just pull this line into the top of the draw loop, like that, and then press restart so I can see my car again. Yay, it's so perfect! And if we want to make the car go faster, we can just change how much we increase x by every time. So if we make it 10, woo, it's off the screen. And I can even make it negative, so x minus 10, and here it comes. Make it positive again, whoops. There it goes. So here are the important things to remember. This thing right here is called the draw loop. You should put your drawing code inside here so it'll get drawn over and over again. And then you want to make a variable outside your draw loop. It's super important to make the variable outside the draw loop so we can reuse the same one every time. Then inside the draw loop right here, we're going to change the variable a little bit, usually by setting it to its old value plus some number, plus or minus some number. And finally, you want to use your variable somewhere in your drawing code so that your drawing looks different every time. And that's it.